actually quite young methodology. Running Lean was about finding problems worth solving. Scaling Lean helped the process of scaling. So what is next, looking into the future? Which questions and topics are currently in your head which you think need more attention?
So in some ways, it's actually going back to the basics. I find that it goes back to a hashtag love the problem. I find that a lot of people have started to make the transformation, but there's still a long way to go. And what I mean by that is that there'll be a team that will say, fine, I'll create a lean canvas, I will fill out my problem box, because that's what the canvas is telling me to do. But a lot of teams will fake that. So they will say, I only want to build a hammer, what problem does a hammer solve? And so everything to you looks like a nail, and we just fake the problems of the lean canvas. And that's not helping, so you can still go out and try to validate that or invalidate that, but we can do better. So I've been more interested in trying to find more effective ways for finding problems worth solving. And it's somehow revisiting even the interviewing techniques I described in the first book and coming up with some better approaches. So I heard somebody in the audience talk about jobs to be done. That's something that I've been digging into quite a bit. That and some of the design thinking techniques, and then trying to find an intersection there where you can use some of those approaches to really find real problems worth solving and not fool oneself. So that to me is where I feel there's a lot of work. Dealing with those unexpected outcomes is another area. So we find a lot of teams will say, I'm pivoting, but when you're pivoting without learning, that's just a disguised see what sticks strategy. And it doesn't really work. People pivot till they give up, and that doesn't help. So how can we look at unexpected outcomes and dig deeper into problems? So that to me is a topic that I think still needs a lot more attention.